Now the On Your Side forecast with Chief Meteorologist Scott Dorval.
The heat is on. That hasn't changed at all, but that smoke has really filled into the region over the past few days with all these fires that have been burning, especially down to the south. We'll look at the locations of those fires again, but I want to show you, as far as temperatures go, all of the west is hot, of course, except right along the coast here where temperatures are cool. Roseburg at 93, 97 in Boise right now, 94 in Twin Falls. Down in Vegas sitting at 99, then a little bit of a break in the temperatures after being well above 100 last week. But it's hot all across the west. That smoke, though, has been an issue. And right here in central Idaho, I'm going to switch computers and show you a satellite, a visible satellite map. This is central Idaho right now, and you can see exactly where the smoke is from these fires. This is the Trinity Ridge Fire. This is the Halsted Fire. I said Holloway before. This is Halsted. This is the Holloway complex down in here. There's some smoke coming up over here with the real strong plumes of these fires. And look at these little fires now beginning to show up here in north central Idaho during the afternoon. That's when you really see the plumes of smoke. So upper level westerly breeze is here, but at night everything settles down. That smoke settles back into the valleys, and that's why it starts to slide on in. This smoke here has been coming in southwesterly winds. It's the smoke from these fires down the south that will disappear from the Treasure Valley tomorrow as our winds swoop in out of the north and west, begin to start changing some of what's going on. All right, let's just switch computers now and show you what's happening with our current weather. 97 in Boise and in Ontario, though they're showing 96 now, had hit 97, 98 Mountain Home, 93. No rain showing up. The radar has been actually picking up the smoke up in the fires here, the Trinity Ridge Fire. The heat continues. Tomorrow will drop that temperature just a little bit again. Fire locations, Halsted, north of Stanley, still hazy in Stanley in the afternoon. Trinity Ridge, there it is right there with all that heavy smoke in the Holloway complex and these fires on down to the south. You see the red and the yellow here. We've got a red flag warning up north of Stanley here. At Stanley to the south, a fire weather watch. So the existing fires, gusty winds and low humidities coming in for tomorrow. The temperature may drop a little bit. This is going to be creating some havoc for firefighters now as the wind is going to fan these fires even overnight tonight, when typically fires tend to settle down. It may flare up even towards morning tomorrow. Thunderstorms have been staying down to the south. The monsoon moisture lurking in central Nevada, but it is not coming to the north. We've got that cold front coming in from the north and west. Cool weather will slide by to the north, but we'll drop our temperatures just a little bit. The difference will be we'll get that northwesterly breeze coming in. That wind change, that wind shift is what's going to make our weather a little bit different tomorrow. We'll clear out some of that smoke during the day. But late in the week, the heat really builds into the west, so the temperatures will stay on the rise, and we may actually see high temperatures around 100 again this weekend. 97 Ontario tomorrow, 94 in Nampa tomorrow, 96 in Meridian Mountain Home, checking in at 98 degrees, improving air quality tomorrow. That's going to be the key. It's tough to tell and tough to forecast, but I think we're going to be in much better shape tomorrow in the Treasure Valley. Areas of smoke, especially Boise County and northern Elmore County, but Long Valley temperatures in the upper 80s, still in the low 90s in Boise County. Some areas of clear skies, if you can find the blue skies, beautiful weather tomorrow. Hazy sunshine, areas of smoke again around Stanley, even Sun Valley will have that as well, especially in the mornings as the smoke settles into the valley, and areas of smoke in the Magic Valley as well, with temperatures around 90 to 95. My underside extended forecast, you see that little bit of a change. We'll get some of the smoke out of the air tomorrow. We'll just call it hazy. It may return for Friday and Saturday as the heat and the southerly breezes come back in. It all depends on how well firefighters get a handle on some of these fires and where the smoke is present. And then, of course, the winds can travel, push it in our direction. Scorching heat returns for the weekend. Saturday and Sunday, upper 90s to near 100. It stays dry through Saturday, but a chance for a thunderstorm or two popping up, mostly in the mountains, during the day Sunday and into Monday as well. There may be a temperature drop on Tuesday. Computer charts are showing it, but some charts are saying it wouldn't change. And so, jury's still out on that Tuesday forecast. We may get a cool down back to the lower 90s, which would be nice. But all eyes turning on the smoke right now. Can we get rid of it? I mean, it was truly like being around a campfire. Hair smelling.
Sure.
It's been that bad.
I put out on Twitter, in fact, I don't know if they can take this in the control room, but I was asking, is it worse to have the smoky air or is it worse to have a winter inversion? Okay, answers so far. Summer smoke inversion feels worse. No scientific basis to that. Somebody else tweeted me back, smoky summer air is worse, at least with an inversion, you can get above it.
It's true. And you could get above this afternoon smoke. Don made a good point, though. It's cold in the wintertime.
It's cold.
There is that. There is that. So anyway, go on Twitter.